Welcome to part 6 of your physical geography online course. This topic we'll be discussing deals with the coastal environment, so I just kind of pulled up the weekly overview to go over some of the content areas. So the first thing that we need to understand is that the oceans and our beach lines themselves are the interface between the lithosphere and the hydrosphere. So it's really a meeting point that's really, really unique. There are going to be discussions of some of the landforms that can be then either built up or can be eroded. Things that we'll be learning about will be waves and how waves themselves are windborne. Windborne far out in the oceans from storms that occur out there and then bring the energy towards, you know, the land itself. You'll also learn about tides and how tides are gravitationally formed and that how that is a bulge of water that rises and then, you know, subsides twice a day. We'll learn that the moon and the sun have an incredible involvement in that. To kind of go back to waves for a moment, you'll learn that there are three types of waves. We've got surging, plunging, and spilling. And what you'll learn is that the difference between those waves really has to do, one, with the energy, but second, with the gradient or slope of the actual beach face itself. We find that during the winter, that the waves become much more energized and they become more aggressive and will cause then steeper beach faces and slopes. Then we'll find that during the summer, waves are much smaller and actually build up more sand against the beach itself and make the waves a lot smaller and more calm. And then you'll learn that there's a difference between the different seasons and how that rolls out into the bigger picture. You'll also be discussing a little bit about currents and how that really helps mix our oceanic water. We'll learn about the thermal haline and that we have a mixture of cold Arctic waters that mixes in the middle with our tropical waters. And because of this mixing, we really keep an environmental balance, a form of equilibrium. Now, if we get to a point that this thermal haline ceases to exist, it is possible that we could experience what's known as Snowball Earth, and that is where the Earth freezes from pole to pole and works its way towards the center, because essentially, if you're not taking warm water and mixing it in areas of cold water, the areas that are cold will remain colder, and the areas that are warm will remain warmer, and the cold areas will soon advance. We'll also move again, like I said at the beginning, towards some landforms. So the landforms that we'll be learning about will be things not just like beaches and berms, but you'll learn about tombolos. You'll learn about spits and groins and even jetties, things that are man-made as well. And we'll learn that there's a really, really interesting balance between human interaction and our coastline. There's a video link that I've shared. It's called River, A Beach of Sand. I really, really suggest that you watch that because it's an older film made in the 1960s, but it really does a great job by using models and using those small types of experiences within those models. They can actually replicate the differences between summer waves and winter waves, summer beaches, winter beaches. We can also see the development of spits and sandbars and how tombolos and lagoons can then be developed within marinas. So it's really a great film. I would really, really suggest that you watch it. The last thing that we'll be dealing with in this chapter is we'll be looking also at just the anatomy of a coastline, moving from the beach all the way out beyond the deep water waves and everything in between, whether it be the surf zone, the breaker, the coast, the trough, wavelengths, wave crests. So there's a lot of different vocabulary and a lot of different features that are both caused either by deposition or erosion. We'll be introducing a lot those two phrases moving forward in this class. We'll be using a lot of erosion, transportation, and deposition. Within those three, that's where we see most of our landforms being developed. Either the waves and or the energy will remove material, which is going to be caused erosion, or we're going to have transportation, meaning that the longshore current takes the sand from north and brings it southward. And then we'll also find that in deposition, that sand gets deposited somewhere. It's deposited in an offshore bar. It's deposited in a marina that can seal it off and create a lagoon, or it can go into a submarine canyon and then really essentially just disappear into the abyss. So again, the big walkway for this big unit itself is understanding tides, currents, and waves. And then we'll wrap it up with the different pieces of the anatomy of a coastline. And then lastly, the features that are identifiable, the ones that are by erosion, transportation, or deposition. Hope you enjoy, and we'll see you soon.